Welcome back, guys. Today we're going to talk about how I was able to make this 125 war win streak, because we have two clans at 50 war win streak and this one already at 25. So it's very simple. How do I do that? It's basically like 80% just depending on me. And here's what I do. I start with every base. So, okay, I start with this first Town Hall 15 base, because Town Hall 14, 13, 12, they're nothing. They're just nothing for me. Anyway, so I have now to claim bases. So I start looking at the base. I just spot the weakness point on any base. So first I took the look, actually before I started recording, on all of the bases, so I don't take that long. But anyway, I kept looking until I saw that 1, 2, 3, they're very good for the zap value, and also this one can be pulled with one balloon or like one hog, which is gonna be perfect. And this mortar can be tanked with the warden, so I can start a warden walk in front of this elixir collector. And actually the flame flinger can take out the town hall, and then I can use probably the zap e titan smash on this base. It should absolutely rock it. So I should now go out and type right here, like it's not necessary, like it's a very easy war, I would say, because look at this stupid enemy. I don't know, oh my god. But when the war is important, I do that. So I just open right here and type E Titan. It's not for my friends, it's for me, so I remember what was my plan on this base. Then I go to the next one. What is the value? I see that okay, we have either this one with this one, or this one with this one, or this one with this one, or whatever. And it's just looking good for the Zap E-Titan as well. So I just type Zap E-Titan. Then I go to the next one. What do we have here? I actually kept looking and saw that the Flame Flinger here could be perfect, because I can take out this mortar with like just distracting it and start the Flame Flinger here. Then Queen charging the Town Hall and finishing off the base with either Lotto or Hogs. Then, next one. Where is the value? I saw that the Blizzard for this one is going to be perfect, because you can see here, like just this distance here between the town hall and the gold storage. If you just land like between the expo and the town hall and trigger that, or like, I don't know, there's a way to keep the super wizard alive. So I just saw that it's gonna be perfect right there, because the poison is kind of far away. So it should be working. We're gonna try that. So next one, what do we have here? I saw that this one is actually, after I kept looking, after like I looked through the base, I said that we have 1, 2, 3. These three buildings, actually the Inferno with the Expo, they should go down, because the distance is 1 by 3. So 1, 2, 3 tiles, and one tile here. So it should be possible, right? With the Grand Warden as well. So that's a very good value. After that, what's the follow-up? It's going to be Lotto. So I'm going to use a Zap Lotto on this one. Zap E-Titan is going to be impossible, I would say. Or maybe it's possible for some players, but for me, I can't find it. However, okay, after I take this out, what am I gonna do? I also have to plan that like initially with myself. So I saw that taking out the town hall with the heroes is not gonna be easy. So I'm gonna use the blimp in the warden's ability, or like maybe late, to take the town hall out. At the meantime, I'm gonna send like maybe the barbarian king, or like maybe start a yeti here, then like the barbarian king to walk to take out this inferno, then like start the queen here, and maybe use the baby dragon or something on these buildings to just push the queen to take out hopefully these buildings, maybe take out the enemy archer queen with the king, and then start Lotto at this point here, and like maybe the RC. I don't know, like I'm just gonna do the Lotto part. It's not something like I plan initially, you know. I just plan how to do the hero sui, and then I don't care about the Lotto. I can do it. Okay, moving on to the next one. All right, seeing in this space, what can I do in this one? What was my plan actually? I saw, yeah, okay, exactly. So I saw that I could either take out these three buildings and do a log launcher Zap Lotto from the opposite side, but I saw that I'm not that good at log launcher usage. So I saw that actually I can take out the monolith with the expo with the invisibility tower, and then I can do the, like maybe the queen of the town hall, king here, to take out these buildings, whatever. It's just gonna make a good pathing for the Lotto, I would say. I don't know. I don't know. This is just the initial plan. So whenever I have this initial plan, I try it in clan wars because it's not a very important war. If it's a very important war, then I look through the base once, twice, three times. I know I have too many attacks, but I'm just used to that. I'm used to that pressure. Moving on to the next one. My plan actually was, I had two thoughts. Either using the blizzard like from right here so that I land on this gold storage and secure the town hall with the expo and this spell tower, and this expo is not gonna go down. Or I had another thought, which is actually sending the blimp from in front of this elixir collector. So I might land right here, like between this builder hut and this gold storage, or I might be lucky and land on the inside, which will get me the town hall. If it doesn't, then it should be right, because the wall also should be open if there is no giant bomb. So landing right here would be good, because if I get the Inferno, the Expo, maybe the other Expo, maybe this one Expo, and the RC, and the CC Bowl, this is going to be enough value for me. Next base. Well, you can see this one, it's going to be absolutely very good for a Blizzard. It's a very easy base, unlike the others. So just a Blizzard from right here, Freeze Sweeper, boom. Land wherever you land, you're going to get an immense value. Then, here is the way this part, a lot of the town hall, that's going to be easy. Anyway, let's start. Okay, so let's plan that again. We got to start the warden like right here, then pull the poison, start this, and I have to distract this monolith. Like, the ice golem will not be enough. So maybe I should get a skeleton spell instead of this freeze spell. Maybe. Or like take another ice golem. Actually, taking another ice golem is going to be ideal. Yeah, I need that freeze. So let's see. Yep, actually that's going to be perfect because I don't need any wall breakers. Yeah, because taking wall breakers might just like let the E-Titans go outside, which is not something I want. Instead, just wall breaking right here, the E-Titans should go across the base. But if I wall break here, then this is gonna be so bad. The E-Titans might just walk to the outside, which is the Barbarian King's job, right? So yeah, it's very important to control the E-Titans pathing. So we're gonna do just that. Okay, here we are after we adjusted the army. We have two ice golems now for this monolith, and we are ready to go. So, everything is set. Yep, we have the flame flinger. Like this. Great. Now, we should start the warden in a way that he is in range of that mortar, just like that. Great. Okay, now let's zap. Very good. Let's go with one barbarian. Okay, there is a Tesla. We start the flinger. Looking good so far. Okay, we have archers. Is there any value? Nah. Now we need to pull the warden. We don't want the warden to do anything up top. So, queen here, just like this. And we want the queen to actually get step closer to this spell factory so that the E-Titans work their way to the monolith. So here's the first ice golem. Shouldn't do much. Okay, perfect, perfect, perfect. Now the monolith should get frozen. We start the king here. And the baby dragon. Okay, we drop the jump spell. Very good. Maybe the king could have come earlier than this. However, we're looking very good. Let's rage up. Do we need to pop the warden's ability? Yup, right now. Okay. Let's go with the hog and a wizard. Now two witches here. Just as planned. Town hall should be secured. We can pop the queen's ability because she's getting hammered, unfortunately. And yeah, and that's not what I was expecting from the E-Titans. Okay, what are they going to do now after the eagle goes down? They're still going after the wall. Okay, that's not bad because we still have the RC. At this point, this space doesn't have that much left. We can pop the king's ability, go with the wizard here, maybe an archer and an archer up top. I forgot to drop the balloons before the healers, which is a mistake that I always do. And at this point, I think I can swag my RC because I don't even need my RC. We can open the flame flinger, pop it open. The Valkyrie, look at the Valkyrie taking out every single one of them. That was so satisfying to watch. However, now we can sprinkle the balloons up top. Let's go like this. We still have a lot of things to utilize, right? We can swag 1, 2, and 3. That's actually 3 spell capacity with the RC swag. Wow, that was so genius. Nice. The E-Titan pathing was perfect. Okay, now let's do the Blizzard Lalo attack. Okay, it was on this base, yep. Which is, I noticed right here, there's a good spot. Let's see if it's gonna work. If it doesn't, it's fine. That's why in wards you have 2 attacks each. So you have plenty of failing opportunities, right? So let's fail. I don't know. I don't think I'm gonna fail. Anyway, on Blizzard Lalo, I don't like to plan the Sui part. I don't like to plan the Lalo part. I like to do it just depending on how the Blizzard goes. Always. This has always been my style on doing the Blizzard Lalo. Even in serious wars, even in clan war leagues, I don't care. I just plan the Blizzard, that's it. So, like this, a balloon. Blimp sails in. Don't go too far, otherwise you're gonna trigger the poison, which is something we don't want. However, one giant bomb was fine. You managed to make it through it. So now, I'm not gonna deploy the next one. What's in the CC? Nothing, so we can start the Archer Queen. All right. Now, the Queen, I think she should go right. Anyway, she has to go right. We can actually drop the Wizard here. Yes, the King is gonna come over, but he is too slow. So this has just secured the pathing 100%. Now we can start the King and a Headhunter right away. Okay, Headhunter goes down, so we send another one. Why didn't I go with the Ice Golem? Because I actually wanted the Ice Golem to go inside. Now, I'm not really sure. Never mind, the Ice Golem is going back inside. Oh my god, that's what I was afraid of. That's why I sent the Goblin, the normal Goblin, but he went to the right. Didn't go to the gold storage. Anyway, now I have to... Let's send another Warbreaker. I don't know where it's going, but let's send RC here with the Wizard. The Queen is being stalled up, which is actually perfect because otherwise she's gonna die to the Monolith. Now we can start the Lalo part. Just like this. Okay. Hound flies over. We can pop the Queen's ability because she is dying. We can freeze here, the perfect freeze. Freeze again, the perfect freeze. Send this and this. And pop the Warden's ability just right now. RC, do we have to invis her? Not yet. Okay, now we need, because the Monolith might lock on, or actually it was locking on. Okay, anyway, I might just disconnect for no reason, for absolutely no reason. We can freeze again and haste, but why am I disconnecting? This is a 3-star. Hello? Let's send all 4 so they can go faster and actually invis them, but I'm disconnecting. You have witnessed it. It's a 3-star, right? What's the problem? I have no clue. And we have the time. Yup, we have the time. Nice. If it disconnects, I'm gonna do it again. I don't care. I have plenty of attacks, right? Yeah, I'm just chilling. I'm chilling. So it looks like I disconnected and didn't triple, but I'm gonna do it again. I don't care. Okay, let's also do another Blizzard Lotto attack, which is going to be the last one for this video. And I'm deciding to go for the more dangerous one, which is going to be from this Elixir Collector. So wherever I land, I have to take that value and work with it. Okay, if I land right here, don't get the Town Hall. I have to send the Archer Queen from the top side to get the Town Hall and maybe send the Barbarian King to the Eagle Artillery section with the Ice Golem, with the Headhunter, with the RC probably, and start out of like just like right here. Yep, that should be perfect. Let's do it. But if I get the Town Hall, what should I do? Maybe just here with the Eagle and be okay with it. Okay, I don't care. Let's just go. This is how random I am. And I like it. I like it. We might go with the balloon first. Now let's send the blimp in. Okay. Not gonna do anything. Okay. We're not gonna make it, just as expected. But we break the walls. So let's see if that's gonna do something. Hello, wizards? Please go back. Please do something. Okay. They are not going to do anything. They are so stupid. So the value is way, way, way less than I was expecting. Anyway, let's do something now with this. Maybe a baby dragon. Okay. Oh, there is an E-Titan. I swear I didn't see it. Okay. It should be fine. Yep. But like, I have to invest the wizard to make sure that queen goes to the town hall. That's wall break by the town hall. Okay, this is not gonna be easy. Like, what should I do? Maybe invest the wizard here to force the queen? Oh, never mind. That is rough. I have no invisibilities. So, okay, queen is not gonna go inside. We have to send the king inside instead. Let's invest the ice golem to protect the queen and send the king directly at the town hall. We might still be able to do this with a, I don't know how, but maybe. Let's pop the king's ability, just secure the town hall. Then what can I do? I don't know. Okay, queen goes inside. Let's start the RC and let's start that auto with the warden's ability right away. Haste our way in. I have no clue if this is gonna work or not, but we're trying. We can pop the queen's ability because she is getting hammered. We can freeze right here and haste. We can send the last lava hound. And this is not going to work. Yeah, this is close, but not gonna work. Yeah, because maybe the blizzard angle was not the best. It was absolutely not the best. But we can freeze. Let's drop some more cleanup. Yeah. This is gonna be a fail. Let's freeze here. And of course, I might do that again.